What's up, guys, and welcome to my channel. Now, if you are a beginner, this video is made for you. In this tutorial, I just want to share a tip that can help you improve the way you sound so that you can sound more like a professional. Now, I'm going to play in the key of F sharp. Now, in the key of F sharp is the 1, A flat is the 2, B flat is the 3, B is the 4, C sharp is the 5, E flat is the 6, F is the 7, and F sharp is the 8 or the 1. Okay, and after sharing this tip with you, I want to give you 5 different ways you can approach the 6. Okay, now I'm going to play the song "Oh Draw Me Near" by Michael Smith. So the song I'm going to play like a beginner, the song goes like this. Okay, let's stop right there. So I played it the simplest way possible. Just a major triad. Okay, now the tip I want to share with you is the following. I'm not going to teach you a B chord. I'm just going to help you use the chord you use all the time and use those chords to sound more professional. Now, here's what I'm going to do. Okay, now you can see the difference. I didn't play different chords. I played the same chord. But then the voicing was different, and this is what makes the difference. Okay, so these grace notes can change the way you sound a lot, okay? Okay, try to use them whenever you can. I'm gonna play a different song so that you can hear how it goes better. I'm gonna play the song "For Your Glory" by Tasha Cobbs. The song goes like this. Okay, so I didn't play B chords, major 9 or 13 or 11, no. I'm just playing the major chords, but what makes it sound this way is that I'm using this grace note a lot. So whenever I can use a grace note, I will do it. Okay, so I also advise you to do the same because it will help you, or it will improve the way you sound. Now, coming down to the 5 different ways you can approach the 6. Now let's come back in the previous song we're playing, which is "Draw Me Near". Okay, now how can you approach the 6? Number 5. Watch this. And as an advice, whenever you play the 6 on your left hand, I advise you to play it using this voicing here. I just like it because it sounds nice. So you have the 6, the 3, and the 1 on your left hand. And then on your right hand, you play the 5. So this will give you a minor 11 chord. Okay, so the passing chord number 5 is the following. Remember the grace note here. Okay, now coming down to passing chord number 4, the following. So this is similar to passing chord number 5. The difference is the inversion. This is a different inversion. I'm still playing the 1 here. So the first one was this one. So this is the 1. But the second one is the following. Okay, I'm still sliding. So this is passing chord number four, coming down to passing chord number six. So this is more of a move rather than a passing chord. You can slide from the two to the seven. Okay. Now, coming down to passing chord number two, I want to play this, the following. Okay, so what did I play? It's actually the six minor, the five major, and the six minor again. But I dropped the second note. I'll play it again. Okay, so you can do that. So coming down to passing chord number one, I'm gonna play. Okay, what did I play? It's a kind of a chromatic walk up. So I started on the 4 sharp. I played the 4 sharp major. So the 4 is the B, 4 sharp is C, C major. Okay, and then I play the 5 major. And then I play the 6 minor. And then I play the 5 major. But remember the grace note here. I play it again. Alright, so that's it guys. I hope you've enjoyed the video. If you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, please don't forget to click on the subscribe button and on the notification icon so that you don't miss any upcoming content. And I thank you all for watching. I'll see you all in the next video. Cheers.